Notice that market is kind of inconsistent over here. We have price increases and price decreases, but for example, let's start over here. Bands are expanding. However, we have some like a pattern over here. Eventually a symmetrical triangle pattern, which means that a low volatility is very high. The price is still consolidating because no substantial trend is created. Suddenly, this triangle is broken in bearish direction. And when this happens, the two bands start expanding. Notice that the expansion is not that big, meaning that the volatility is not that high. Then suddenly we have a breakout over here. The price returns again to the lower band, creates a spinning bottom candle, and then it increases again, breaking D. 20 period moving average going in the buy zone of the Bollinger band indicator. But again, bands are not that wide. So the market is not very consistent over here. Take a look. Then the price, the Bollinger bands are squeezed again. Price returns again to the lower level of the band. Another squeeze over here. So this is kind of like a moment of inconsistency for the Bollinger band indicator. Again, another run, but if you try to trade all of these, for example, if you buy here, then when the price increases, you may be forced to sell somewhere over here. So how much is this? Like 7 pips. When you put the spread of the Euro Swiss franc forex spread, that might not be enough for your trades, right? Then again, another squeeze. However, we have something interesting over here. Take a look. After this bearish move, price bounces in bullish direction, breaks the 20 period moving average, starts hitting the upper band. The bands like start expanding like in a normal way here. And then the price starts moving sideways.